Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Good morning. So today we're going to be talking about the book of 1 Thessalonians, chapter 5, verses 16 to 18. And it reads, "Rejoice always, pray continuously, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus."
Amen.
So Apostle Paul wants to remind us, in this verse, he wants to remind us to always rejoice and always have a cheerful heart.
Amen.
For me, when my siblings left for college, everything changed for me. My whole mood just It changed. Before, when they were here, I was always happy and I was an active kid. Now that they're gone, I sometimes feel lonely and I feel sad that I have no one to hang around with and no one to talk to at home. Before, we used to go home and they used to do their homework and I would always annoy them. And but now, I go home, I just sit there, just do my homework and listen to my music, just wishing that I had someone to talk to or hang around with. But I still have my parents and I still have you guys to keep me happy and to keep my head up. And thank God for you guys. My parents, they bring joy to my life. They're the reason why I'm always, they always keep me, they keep me entertained by giving me a chore. Tell me to do that. Apostle Paul also, he also reminds us to pray continuously. Pray without ceasing. Never stop praying. Because once you stop praying, you're opening a gate for the devil to come into your heart.
Amen.
Never stop praying. Don't ever cut that line, the communication line with God.
Amen.
When you feel down and you had a long day at school or work, and you feel stressed with all your homeworks, or you feel stressed at work, wherever you are, just go into a private place or the bathroom and just get on your knees. Get on your knees and pray. Talk to God. Give all your problems to Him and He'll take care of everything for you. Apostle Paul also reminds us to be thankful and be appreciative for what we have. American Samoa is a territory of the U.S. And the U.S. provides for us. So we have everything down here. But we tend to be unappreciative and ask God for this and that and not think about what we already have. Sometimes we ask God for stuff, for things that we don't need. And it reminds me of something that Pastor Ellen said on Friday when we had our subgroup here. She said, when you ask God for something and it doesn't happen, sometimes it takes time for it to happen. But also, it can mean that God didn't make it happen because he knows that it might drift you away from him instead of drawing you closer to him and having a closer relationship with him. So, there's a saying that during a test, the teacher stays silent. So when you're having rough times, when you're having rough times and you ask God, why is this happening to me? Why me? You ask why? I like to think that God is standing, is sitting on his throne in front of a pillar with a ball. He's watching you and he's staying silent. He's testing you. And he's trying to see if you can go through the storm, if you can get through the storm. Life is a test from God. So when you're going through rough times, just know that he is testing you. He is letting these things happen to you because he knows that you can go through the storm. You can go through the rain. We're practicing on Saturday. And there's a song. I don't know the name, but it goes, he didn't promise that there would be no rain. He only promised a heart full of singing or something like that. But that song, it reminds me that life is a test. And when you're going through rough times, just get on your knees and pray and give it to God. And yeah, we're going away from the what? But we have to be appreciative for what we have. Because in some countries, they don't have what we have. Some countries, they're wandering around looking for food and water or shelter just to get through the day. Or find a roof over their head just so that they can sleep through the night. That's what we should think of. We should thank God for what we have. It says, thank God in all circumstances, whether it's good or bad, just thank God. Because if you're having a rough day and you're asking God, why me? Why? There's always someone that's having a worse day than you. So thank God no matter what. If you're going through a rough time, thank God. As I conclude today, I stand here before you guys and I declare that without the help of the Holy Spirit, without the help of Jesus Christ, the Lord and Savior, I wouldn't be here doing all this. I would have been in the choir. I wouldn't be here at church preaching to you guys, and I wouldn't have the strength to do anything that I can do right now in life. That also reminds me of another thing that Pastor Helen said. In the book of John 15, chapter 5, it reads, I am the vine, you are the branches. If you remain in me, and I in you, you will bear much fruit. You drift apart from me, and you are nothing. You cannot do anything. So, he's basically saying that if you have that close relationship with him, then anything can happen. Anything is possible through God. You can do anything through him. Without him, we're nothing. Yeah. Without Christ, Jesus Christ, we can't do anything. Without him, we can't. So, I encourage you guys to have that close relationship with him, to read your Bible and pray every day so that you can be close with him. Because when if you don't do that, and it comes to the day of the judgment, and you walk up to the gate of heaven, and he's standing there, and you say, God, it's me. He's just going to turn his back and say, I never knew you. So I encourage you guys to pray and read your Bible. Not only read the Bible and pray, but you got to follow the steps of Jesus Christ. Amen. You got to walk the path, walk straight. Fix your eyes on God. Because the devil works so hard. For example, you're walking in a straight path. Yeah? Jesus Christ and the Lord is right there standing in front of you. But the devil is on the sidelines, just trying to reel you off the path. He's trying to get you off of that path so that you won't go to heaven. Because Jesus, he failed God once and he got kicked out of heaven. But we fail God daily. And he gives us a second chance, not a second chance, not a third, but he gives us 1,000 chances. Amen. That's why the devil hates us so much. Because he failed God once and he got kicked out of heaven. We fail God daily. He never gives us, he gives us a second chance. Amen. So I encourage you to pray and read the Bible and follow the steps of Jesus Christ. Ignore all the world and the flesh things. Ignore all of that. The devil is working so hard to try and kick you off that path. He hates us because God gave us a second chance. So, I encourage you to repent before it's too late. Repent now before it's too late, because God is coming soon. He is coming very soon. And when it comes to the day of judgment, and you didn't repent, he's going to turn his back on you and say, go away from me, for I never knew you. So repent before it's too late. Finally, I just want to thank you guys for helping me throughout my life, throughout my journey. Thank my parents, pastors, New Hope Center. Thank all you guys for helping me grow closer to God. And without you guys, without my parents, I would have never knew who God was. I would have been lost in the world. I would have been somewhere in the streets looking for drugs or alcohol or looking for money. Just lost in the world without you guys. I would have been like that without my parents. So I thank you guys. All this I say in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Good job, people.
Thank you, Brother Bam. How many of you are ready to repent now?
think about the goodness of the Lord. He gives me everything I need and so much more. So I just want to lift my hands and say that I love you. I just want to lift my heart in
teachers. Thank you so much for continuing to teach our children. We thank the Lord together this morning, and this will conclude the children's performance this morning.
next building. Please, everyone, please stretch forth your hand and let's pray for our children. Father, we praise you and thank you. Lord, your word says, unless the Lord build the house, we labor in vain. Unless the Lord keep the city, the watchmen are watching in vain. Lord, we thank you for the families. Thank you, Lord God, for each and every family represented here this morning. Lord, and we thank you for these children. And I pray, Lord, for excellent spirit to be upon them, that you are going to fill them with your Holy Spirit, word of wisdom, word of knowledge, Lord. Excellent spirit, that they will stand out, Lord God, from the spirit of the world. Lord, we thank you, we praise you, Father, for this Sunday school teachers. I pray, God, that you will give them wisdom and anointing, Lord God, to teach the children in the way that they should go. And when they are old, they will not depart from the original teachings. And we thank you, Lord God, for this morning. Bless our children indeed. And Lord, may they grow up fulfilling their destiny in the kingdom of God. And we thank you for each and everyone here this morning. May your grace be upon us. May your countenance be lifted upon us, Lord. And may you be gracious unto us and give us peace and your joy. We thank you, we praise you. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 Thank you.
You're going to cut the cake.
Father, we thank you for this time of fellowship and for this food that we're about to receive. Help us to enjoy our fellowship together with you and with one another. Bless our children, Lord, and bless this food to our bodies. We thank you for providing. In Jesus' name,
amen.
Think about